Now here comes the third thought. It comes from our co-founder, Dr. Stephen R. Covey. Of the hundreds of wise things he said and the many books just dedicated to his own quotes, he said something that's changed me forever. And it's this idea of, with people, slow is fast and fast is slow. It's prophetic. Think about it. Most of us treat people like we treat things or processes, right? We're inherently rewarded for being efficient versus effective. And if maybe not you, definitely me. I constantly get confused and fall into the trap of treating my relationships like I treat toast. You say toast? Let me give you the metaphor. Have you ever been to the hotel breakfast buffet, especially in a large hotel, where they have the industrial toaster? Not the 4 or 5 or 6 slice toaster, but the conveyor toaster, where you take your bread out of the loaf, you put it on the little rack, you turn the dial to, you know, 2 or 3, and in a minute or 90 seconds, it runs your toast around, your toast comes out toasted. Well, I really struggle with that mind-numbing technology, because for me, I cannot wait the 45 seconds it takes for my toast to come out. So inherently, I walk up to it and I immediately turn it to the number 9, the fastest number, put my toast in because I want it out fast. And invariably, it either comes out still raw, so to speak, or I have to put it in 2 or 3 times, when instead, if I would just leave it on the 2 setting, put my toast in, take a deep breath, walk over, you know, take a glass of orange juice, get a cup of coffee, get my eggs, come back, my toast would come out a minute later, all toasted. I use that metaphor because I think that toaster is the way I treat many of my relationships. Now don't get me wrong. Hopefully you know, if you've met me, I really value my friendships and relationships. In fact, I was really inspired by Todd's book around relationships. And I'm also quite proud of my own productivity. I like to get things done. We say at Franklin Covey, no one's ever going to hire me to deliver a funeral eulogy or a Thanksgiving prayer, but I'll be the first person hired to evacuate you from a burning building. Now, you might need therapy on the way down, but I will get you out alive. I like to get things done, and I have a very sort of efficient mindset. What I need to be mindful is not letting that productivity mindset rule my relationships. With people, slow is fast, and fast is slow. Here's a great example. About 20 years ago, I was a salesperson in our education division. My job was to sell leadership development solutions to community college, university and college professors and administrators. I was at a specially important meeting with the provost. I think she was the vice president of business and provost at a major top 10 university in size in the Midwest. And we'd had some conversations. They were an ongoing client, but we had a kind of a big deal on the table. Well, they were thinking of training in excess of 1,000 people in one of our solutions. Very exciting, especially as a salesperson. We go to the meeting and I invite our vice president then of education, Chuck Farnsworth, who was sort of the polar opposite of me. He's very laid back, 20 years my elder, very wise, very deliberate. We go to the dinner, and no sooner had our menus arrived, I push the menu aside, slide up my chair, and start to launch into the, sort of the business conversation. I'm not sure our waters had even been poured yet. And like it was yesterday, I remember Chuck, appropriately, putting his hand on my knee, kind of squeezing it under the table, and very delicately and gently redirecting the conversation over to some just pleasantries, right? Finding some common ground. How are you doing? How's the summer in Ohio? What are some goals you're trying to accomplish? What are some of your struggles? It was a very, for Chuck, effervescent, natural conversation. For me, it was like, you know, infuriating because I wanted to get to the business at hand. But in fact, the business at hand was just building some sincere commonality, right? Some rapport, some camaraderie. And in due time, Chuck got to the business. And in fact, we won the business. But had we not, Chuck wouldn't have changed his style because he was all about investing and listening and learning slowly with the other person. Now, I'm still, as you can tell, fairly energetic. I have a bias to action. I'm somewhat impulsive and impetuous. And some would say it makes me endearing, not my wife. But some might say they like that about me. But I struggle, really struggle, with making sure that I don't take that same sort of bias to action at dinner with my relationships. And the thought from Stephen, with people, slow is fast and fast is slow is never more relevant now when all of us are at hyper speed trying to accomplish more, multitask, live in the real world, manage our digital worlds, all of our many roles. I just caution everyone to be mindful of that thought, that take your time with your relationships, because in life, it's all that matters.